there's a lot of cool things going on. A lot of Battle of the Bands about to go on or something. A lot of plot. Stage 2 plot. I think I've had enough of being led around. If this is what's going to happen, we should at least have it happen on our terms. Remember what we talked about. The alternative would be for us to be separated again. So, ideally, take the job, win the thing, go back home, don't deal with shit. Except that'll probably happen, and then, you know, other shit will happen. So, you know, whatever. Because it's only the prelude. Togo looks at Nadia hesitantly and squeezes back. Then, in a self-reaffirming way, I'm surprised it's not reassuring, but she grabs onto Epiphany's strap. Thinking about their conversation last night, Epiphany seems to hum back to her. Fine, I'm going to go, but not for any of you. Not for your stupid titles, I'll go for Nadia. For Epiphany. But mostly for Nadia. Because we got that thing going on now. I get to choose the band's name. It's gonna be the Reject Demon Togo. If it is, I'm gonna kill someone. Got a name? Of course not. I didn't know that there was going to be a band until 5 minutes ago. Gid ignores the two of them by checking her wallet. Meanwhile, Nadia isn't sure at what point she's going to get involved in an argument between sisters. I have no problem with being solo, by the way. Usually, you don't threaten to break up the band until you at least got a couple of hits. And actually, you know, the band has a name and it's been formed properly, but besides the point. I'll hit you a couple times if that's what you want. Yeah, no, Gid's like, relax, let's go eat. Here, eat. Small sugar dumpling. Togo can have mine. She's the only one who needs to relax. Not hungry. No, just force it into their mouth. Togo stifles a laugh as Gid forces the dumpling into Devon's mouth. Fine, give it here. Togo eats the dumpling herself, still amused. Are you two done? No, I'm not going to be done with Devon for another eon. So many eons. Okay, Gid moving back and forth. Like, I'm done. I'm glad my little sister is so interested in me. Did you forget what happened yesterday? Watches like the whole, like, I was holding back the entire time, I swear. So mad about the fake kidnapping? I didn't interject here, but it wasn't fake to me. Exactly, that was just yesterday. What about the rest of our lives, huh? Do you think I'm going to forget that just because I got tricked into joining a band? No, don't forget it all. Alright, you're dead to me. Togo finds herself gagged by another dumpling. I never knew anyone who could get so worked up over nothing. Quite as spectacularly as you, Togo. It's all your fault. Be a better demon next time, and next time you want to have people take it away from you or something. I don't know. It's all your fault. Now as we are bandmates, we should act like colleagues, right? Let's agree to not fight until we're done with hell on earth. But I want to fight more. I think we need more than an arrangement not to fight. Oh, tomorrow I'm going to the concert. I got my friend to get me an extra ticket, Togo. I can get some too. No, stop it. Nemi Tenshi Tenshi. More fun than you realize, Nadia. I'm interested. Gin, shall we do some family bonding through the power of pop music? As long as I can get to the freshman stance in time. Alright, yeah, no, she's totally a demon. That's obvious as crap that this girl's a demon. Probably a demon for the band we're about to go fight off. Because why not? Devon is headed off to wherever she made her... Yeah, where are they living now? Togo follows behind Nadia on the walk back to the apartment, and now Togo's gonna get a job at some point. Hello, Togo. Look at that. It's Gin. For some reason. Why? What? Aren't you the one who talked to us first? Togo knows she isn't very good at this sort of thing. Apologies aren't something demons Togo needs. Yeah, the Togo needs to apologize. For some reason. What are we apologizing for now? Never mind. Apparently we don't know. Oh, what are we giving? Human food. Yay. Maybe Togo is not so bad after all. No, Togo's pretty bad. Eat your food. Eat your gift food. I understand Togo has trouble expressing emotions. Emotions are hard to express. They're very hard. Thank you, Toko. Bye-bye. Leave us alone. Bye. Go eat your gift somewhere else. Extremely eventful day. Yeah, no, it's extremely eventful. Too eventful for anyone, basically. So now you have to start a band. You have to learn how to play a guitar, bass guitar. And then you have to go win the battle of the bands, watch a concert, and shit. Everything's gonna happen. Steph was able to get tickets for Devon and Gin, so the five of us will get to enjoy together. Backstage passes too. I'd say you stole some backstage. Lovely.
You were getting a profit off that now.
Coming to bed? Yeah, no, same bed, still. Anything other to say than yeah. Yeah. I imagine you have lots of things in your mind, but is there something really bugging you right now? Everything. Have you been to one of these concerts? Plenty of times. It's gonna be your first concert on Earth. I meant with this Nemi person. Oh no, this is the first time. It might be the only chance I'll get to see without spending a fortune. Got it. I look forward to it, and now we're gonna figure out who this Nemi person is. Because obviously everyone here but Nadia knows. Because I would like to know, like, what demon person this person is. Because it's obvious as shit this is a demon. Let's go off. Choco's in bed, and now we're gonna go to sleep. Or not. What do you need advice for?
Go to the sleep place.
Not yet. I still have the same worries. Or you still have the same worries, right? Of course I do. But I bet Devon noticed it too. She wouldn't care, though. Well, she probably doesn't think there's anything actually wrong. She only heard the name. It's cute that you're trying to care, though. Oh, look at that. Who's gonna get hurt now? How are you exhausted? You didn't do shit. All you did was just be on my back the entire day. After complaining for so long that I wouldn't listen to her, great. Toko cuddles up to Nadia, relaxing in the warmth of her body. The worries about how tomorrow could go... I know how to say that word too.
I am a terrible reader.
So we get to the first breaking point of this. All right, so we're at the concert now. Amazingly lovely. There she is. I knew it. It's Demon Girl. Hello, my adorable, lovely fans. I'm so glad to meet you. Yeah, no, she called you lovely. Be careful, she's an angel. Ooh, she's an angel. Angel, one of the denizens of heaven. Kind of like demons who live in hell. Yeah, no, angels are real too, apparently. Alright, so that's better then. Angel instead. Are angels douchebags? Toko, what about mermaids? I have... Yeah, no, that now we're going down. There are... Are you enjoying yourselves? The angel noticed us. Wait, so Toko wouldn't be considered a demon right now, would she? Because she's technically being human. Nemi leans in eerily close to Toko and gives her a wink. Glad to hear it. But are you sure you're meant to be here, miss? Toko, I was invited. I have a ticket. I'm pretty sure I'm meant to be here. Invited? That makes sense. So, now the demon's getting all over the demon. Let's get some of that action going on. I trust you, Miss Toko, to not cause a scene. I know how unruly you and your kind can get. Oh, that's just rude. Okay, hold it. I'm not letting that go. We both know what's up. I don't care what you do here with your fans, but don't insult me. Define what's up. Maybe catches something strange in Toko's tone. I apologize for insulting you, Miss Toko. I will let you insult yourself with your own actions. That's rude. This is an amazing idol. Nemi leans into Nadia's ear. You brought a creature from hell here. Do you even know what you're getting into? No. I've been pretty confused for the past 3 days. I've only just discovered the whole angel thing 2 minutes ago, and I don't even know what you're here for. But my girlfriend is still a guest of yours. Ooh. Drop that bomb already. Girlfriend, a demon with a human. You know, it's adorable, I swear. Well, it's not my thing to get in the way of true love. Enjoy yourselves, you two. Yeah, get out of here. Angel. Are angels bad people? Like, why? I don't... Whatever. I know pop stars aren't quite what they appear to be, but wow. What does an angel even have? Why does Angel want to be pop star? Hunger, just like demons. While we'll take you as you are, angels seek out what they deem to be the best in humanity. Think of it as being gourmet, only... Wow. Okay. So, they only eat the best? If you gave them a plate of food, they wouldn't even finish every bite. Talk about being picky. That's funny coming from you. Demons eat you as it is, and then the angels are like, no, you gotta fit to my standards. I'm the cool one. Still, does she eat during the concert? I guess if you don't mind everyone knowing who you are, then gathering them in one place makes it easy to find, or easy to feed. That is creepy. At worst, they can pull out everything that makes a human human, leaving them a husk to develop all over again. What? Yeah, how often does this happen? Almost never. It's not allowed, and they usually aren't interested. Because they're so picky about what they eat, they tend to push people to do as much good as possible. What monsters? Yeah, what? Whether humanity actually benefits is irrelevant to them, though. And Nebby is the type to take it too far, then I should do something about it. Too far? And why is it your job? By the way, I think we're being watched. Yeah, see that giant guy at the door? I'm not sure how I missed him. Ezra? The wall almost seems to move as a man steps towards the front of the wall, front of the hall with the stature of a mountain. Why? He grunts as he walks and reverberation makes... Wow, so this guy's... There's two angels here. He's presumably working for Nemi. Okay, Togo, we should get out of here. Shall we go find Steph now? Sure. I just have to check on something super quick. I'll be with you as soon as I get... Yeah, no. We're gonna go do plot-related things. Hold on. She moves so fast when she wants to. Maybe she needed to pee. Probably not. Who am I kidding? It's going to be trouble. Wait, why are you outside suddenly? What? Outside the school? A route to and from hell, of course. Good point. Yeah, no, good point. How long is that elevator ride? Just about the Bellatrix. Oh, I skipped that by accident. Whoopsies. Scroll up. Surprise me Toko's not here. Or is she hiding behind you? Nope, not here. She said she'd catch up. And now I don't know where she went. I bet she's lost. Well, no. Demons have cell phones. Well, you guys not have phones? I feel like Gin's the only one who has a cell phone, right? Yeah, of course. Gin's the only one who's with it. Amazing. It is how humans order a food known as pizza. Amazing. Then do... Wait, how does it work? No, now Devon needs to have one. She needs to have the cell phones. And now she's no longer over there. Right down the backstage hallway, Toko goes door to door searching through various dressing rooms for Nemi. Toko didn't mean to ditch Nadia, but she knew she'd object if she saw her daring to do something stupid, basically. She's certain Nemi is doing something out of line with the audience, something that could damage them permanently. She wasn't sure just what it could be, but, you know, it's probably something important. You know, angels are so stupid. Like, there she is. Surprised you're still here. You even ditched that girl of yours. So, I wonder what's gonna happen now. Go back to heaven and leave those people alone. I'm not even trying to feed off people. So, angels do feed off people, but they feed off only the good ones? Like, what? Unless you're going to get mad at demons for hovering around a poor dying man like a vulture. Well, I mean, that's what they do. But they feed off the dead people. So, I don't really know if that's as bad, but, you know, whatever. I love how they always make the... If you're introduced to demons first, angels seem like the bad people. I see. You're here because you're mad at me for breaking some kind of ancient rule. What ancient rule are we breaking? You don't strike me as someone who cares much for rules. In fact, I distinctly remember you claiming you didn't care about what I did to my audience. This is different. You know, those rules were put in place for a reason. to not... do the thing. Not wanting to say the first thing that comes to her mind, maybe she remembering something her dad told her. Or it doesn't quite sit right with her. Or that, or the angels, you know, being so brazen about trying to eat the peoples. The whole, sustainability thing. True, if phrased awkwardly. But, you know, we had people in charge of aberration. Nobody said anything to me about it. Find a witch and make her stop me. Until then, there's no reason to... Wait, a witch? Why a witch? What? Go take a... Okay. Unless you were hiding something. No, we're hiding everything. Some people are about to die today. What's the real reason you're here? To not have people die? Or do you not actually know? What does that even mean? You're hiding something. And you're hiding it from me. And hiding from yourself. Amazing. What? None of this makes sense to me. So I'm just going to keep reading. That's all I can do. Just that before you do something you regret, you take the time to really understand why you feel the need to be so rudely belligerent to the idol your girlfriend so admires. That doesn't mean shit, really, but okay. Hey, look, it's Big Dude. Please escort my fan from the premises. Won't be that easy, trust me, it will. Break her in half, Ezra. Goodbye. Oh, he's big. How scary. He never hit something small, and there's no way he could. No, focus on two targets at the same time. We're gonna strike a pose. We don't know how to use Epiphany yet, though. So. Duncan finds himself standing there with nothing but a silent... yeah, you don't know how to play your guitar yet, so. Ezra reaches back and, like a falling redwood, swings towards Toko, who barely manages to slide past it. That was, okay. His arm buries itself halfway into a brick wall. Wow, that guy's pretty strong. Had Toko been a fraction of a second slower, she'd been turned into a building... you would've been dead, basically. Time to walk away. Before she can move, Ezra swings his buried arm towards Toko, ripping it out of the wall and nearly tearing the hallway in half. Toko ducks, panicking as long... So why can't you use your bass guitar? Is it because you don't know how to play it? Toko rolls and scampers to her feet before running down the hallway as fast as she can. She has to figure out what's going on with Epiphany somewhere safe. Why even pick a fight if you're going to duck and run? Okay, now just go kill the demon. Just go do it. Toko puts her hand against the wall, pausing to catch her breath. Okay, Epiphany. I'm well aware you can do the thing, but come on, do the thing. Definitely not my fault. I didn't get a good rest. Sleepy? How can you need so much sleep? We only talked for half a minute last night. Yeah, so, what's with that? As much as you may want me to perpetuate a dynamo of badness, really? Or badass,